Welcome to 5 Minutes in the Word, a daily devotional in the Word of God.
Growing up, I was always told, son, remember who you are.
And that was a really important lesson for me because as I went from place to place, I did need to remember who I was and who I was representing. That I wasn't just representing myself, I wasn't just representing my family, but I was representing, you know, my friends, my people I went to school with. I was representing a whole lot of people. And most importantly, I was representing the church and representing God. And I think that's a lesson for all of us to recognize that we too need to remember who we are, that as we go as Christians from place to place, we need to remember who we are. We need to remember what kind of life we're to be living. And so today I want us to turn over to 1 Peter in chapter 2, starting there in verse 9. It says, but you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his own possession, that you may proclaim the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. This is telling us who we are as Christians. We're a chosen race. And I know so many of us, when we think about this idea of being chosen, that we get a little confused because there's people out there that think, okay, well, God chose who he's going to save, that he picked, you know, Mary and Susie and Bob, but he didn't pick other people. No, God chose that he was going to save those that were obedient before him, those that would submit to his will and that would follow after him. He chose that his group of people that he was going to save, and it wasn't name by name, but it was based on the conditions of salvation and how we lived our life and how we are obedient before him. And so we can be part of that chosen race if we will choose to follow him, that we are a royal priesthood, and we are to be a royal priesthood. We're to live and to serve and to worship the Almighty God. We're to be the holy nation. We're to be pure and set apart for God. We're to be his own special people. And that's what it goes on to say, a people for his own possession. We get to be God's people. He gets to be our Father. We get to have Jesus Christ and be part of all of his family. We get to be a part of that. And it says that you may proclaim the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. You see, now when we recognize who we are, we have to admit, we have to confess, and we have to show people that Jesus Christ has saved us. He has brought us out of darkness, out of the sinfulness of this world, and now he has moved us into now to being part of him and to be in that marvelous light of God. And now that is where we get to live. Verse 10 says, once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. Beloved, I urge you as sojourners and exiles to abstain from the passions of the flesh, which wage war against your soul. Keep your conduct among the Gentiles honorable, so that when they speak against you as evildoers, they may see your good deeds and glorify God on the day of visitation. You see, as a kid, when my mom told me, son, remember who you are, you know, she wanted me to represent myself well. She wanted me to represent the family well. But I think most importantly, she wanted me to represent God well, to remember that I am a child of God, that I am a Christian, and that I am supposed to be living for him. And if we will conduct ourselves in that way and we will live for God, then God is going to be the one that gets glorified. Not me, not someone else, but God. God receives the glory that is given because of how his people are living on this life. So let's live today. Let's conduct ourselves well. Let's conduct ourselves pleasing and acceptable before God, and remember who we are. Remember, we are God's special people, and we are to live as such. We are to conduct ourselves the way God has told us to do, and one day he will come and he will take us home.